हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर सुषमा पीजीटी हिस्ट्री फ्रॉम जवाहर नवोदय विद्यालय मनकापुर गोंडा. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू चैप्टर 9 ऑफ क्लास 11, दैट इज द इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन. सो दिस चैप्टर इज डिवाइडेड इन टू पार्ट्स. इन फर्स्ट पार्ट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर व्हाट वर द कॉजेज ऑफ द इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन, व्हाई इट हैपेंड इन ब्रिटेन एंड व्हाट वाज द कंडीशन ऑफ वर्कर्स. Then later we will be discussing in the next part. Okay. Now first of all we are going to deal with the meaning. Industrial Revolution. What is the meaning of Industrial Revolution? Now see in this what happened. What were the changes? Previously the goods were produced in houses by hands. Now the change occurred. Now goods were produced in factories. That was the major change. Means from houses. And by hands, right? Now they were produced in factories. That was the major change. Now the surplus production started and there was need to export it. So what is the meaning? Means the production was started, production was done in houses by hands. Now it was done in factories. That was the major thing in Industrial Revolution. Now how do we know? These changes were brought through machines. The machines brought the change. How do we know? The sources are Arnold Toynbee, then other historians like T.S. Ashton, Paul Montox and Eric Hobson. The work of these historians tell us, they give us a lot of details about Industrial Revolution. So, if we go through the works of these historians, we will come to know what was Industrial Revolution and how did and why did it happen, right? Now, the next thing is, First Industrial Revolution, that was from 1780 to 1850. This happened in Britain and the major change came in economic and political sector also. The change was industrial and in economic sector of Britain from 1780 to 1850. Okay, so the focus was in the beginning, the focus was on textile industries. Mainly they were dealing with the textile industries. Now the next thing is, what were the reasons why it happened in Britain? You know, Britain was unified. Britain, Scotland, Wales and England, they were unified under one monarchy. So Britain was the first country to experience Industrial Revolution because Scotland, Wales and England, they were unified under one monarchy. This was the main reason and this paved the way for Industrial Revolution. Because of this, if you are working under one ruler, definitely you are going to follow the same rules and regulations. Same laws. Means there was uniformity of laws, there was uniformity in economic system, there was uniformity in political system also. So this all paved the way for Industrial Revolution. So, and one more thing was, the money became the medium of exchange. That was also main thing. The other thing, one more thing, you can see, that time, agricultural revolution also took place. In 18th century, agricultural revolution took place in Britain. Especially when we say Britain, we are especially talking about England because that was the main center. Now, large estates were created. Agricultural revolution, because of this, large estates were created and when there are small pieces of land, then definitely the production will not be very good. When large pieces were created, then they were using machines. With the help of technology, they were producing more and more food. So, because of agricultural revolution, more food stuff was produced. Now, when they were doing this thing, when this agricultural law was passed, then what they were doing, all the nearby lands, they were joined together. Nearby lands were joined together. Those who were residing on that land, they had to shift somewhere else. They were grazing their cattle also there. They had to shift somewhere else. Either they moved to the nearby cities or they were in search of job in the factories because factories were in the process. They were in the process of setup. So, they shifted to other places because of agricultural revolution. Now, we are going to discuss the main causes of industrial revolution. Here you can see main causes are given. Now, what were the causes? Now, if we say, what are the conditions required for setting up the factory? This is a common thing I am going to discuss here. Industrial Revolution was a cause there, but when I say what were the main causes of set, what are the main reasons or the factors to set up the factory, then what do you say? You will say for establishing factories, factories can be set up where? What are the conditions? Number one, what do you need? First of all, you need money. First of all, you need money. Secondly, you need land. Third, you need government support. Then, what else you need? You need transport. Okay, then transport is required. Now, what else is required? Markets are also required. Okay, market is also required. Then the liberal policies of the government, that is also there. Then banking system is also required. So these are the basic things. These are the basic. But when we talk about that in the terms of this one, in the terms of industrial revolution, just you can go through it. Political stability, just now I told you there was political stability in Britain because Scotland, Wales and England, they were unified under one monarchy. So there was political stability, they were having common laws, then there was single currency, banking system was also developed there, then they were also having so many colonies. India was the colony of Britain at that time. Then so many inventions had been done till this time. Then introduction of railways and canals also for the transportation of the goods. Then availability of coal and iron. Iron was available. Iron is used for what? For manufacturing machine. Okay. Iron was used for manufacturing machine and coal was used as a fuel. So coal was there. Iron was there. Many inventions were there. Inventions had taken place. They had a lot of money also. Then Britain had made many countries as their colony. Britain was having many colonies. What they were doing? They were getting raw material from the colony. And what they were doing again? They were dumping manufactured goods in the market of those colonies. So they had colonies. They had a lot of money also. And they were investing these money in the business, in industries. Then labor was also available. Labor was available because of decline of feudalism. At that time, feudalism declined. And those who became jobless, they were in search of job. They were ready to do any work at any cost, right? Then, now, towns, trade and finance. Just go through it. What were there at that time? From 18th century, many towns in Europe were growing in areas and in population as well. Then, out of 19 European cities, 11 were in Britain. And the largest one of them was London. London was a hub. That was the main center, main market. Now the trade shifted from the Mediterranean ports of Italy and France to the Atlantic port of Holland and Britain. London replaced Amsterdam. Amsterdam was enjoying good position. Now it was replaced by London. So London became the center of primary trade between England, Africa and West Indies. Now development of transport system. As you know, when the trade is developed, when you are manufacturing something, then you need raw material. How the raw material will come to the factories? Through transport. How the manufactured goods will go to the market? Through transport again. So, in the beginning only waterways were there. Railways were not introduced till now. Later they were introduced. So, through waterways, because this was the cheaper and the fastest at that time. When we say cheaper, the fastest, that time it was right there. So canals were built, and especially the first canal was built for the purpose of taking coal from the center to the factories. So they were using waterways. Later on, one more thing, why this happened in England? Because of the banking system. Banking system developed in England. First bank was founded in 1694. First bank, Bank of England, this was known as Bank of England, that was founded in 1694. Then many more banks were established, and by the 1820s, you can see more than 600 banks were there, and out of these 600, 100 banks were in London alone. Now coal and iron, they are the main content, you can say, for setting up the factories. Now, this coal was abundantly available in Britain. Iron was abundantly available in Britain. So, what they were doing, they were taking the coal or iron to the factories. Later on you will see what problems were there and how they sorted out this problem. Coal was there, and especially those who were rich at that time, what they were doing, they were involved in this business. So rich, those who were rich, not only in coal, Britain was rich in other material also, in other metal also, which were required for setting up the industries. They were lead, copper, tin, they were also required for industries. A lot of coal was available, but there was scarcity of good iron. Iron was there, coal was there, but there was that iron was not usable, because what sort of iron they were willing for was required for the factory, that was not available in Britain, because the process of smelting of iron was not there. That technology was not developed till that time. For smelting the iron, high temperature is required. They were using charcoal for smelting of iron, and this was not producing high temperature. So some changes were brought, and later on smelting of iron, the process changed. Now you can see here some iron and coal manufacturing areas are given here. Especially you can see Manchester, Liverpool, then Birmingham, Leeds, Lancashire. They were the main centers of iron and coal, and London also, of course. How can we forget London? So this was for iron and coal. And again, when we will discuss about textile and cotton, again you will see the same areas. So these areas, Manchester, Birmingham, Sheffield, London, Lancashire, these were the main centers of coal and iron, right? Then iron masters. When we say masters, that means they had mastery in something. Iron masters, who were known as iron masters in Britain? They were the Derby family. Derby was the surname. So Derby family, three generation of Derby family, they served in this field. First Derby, he invented blast furnace, and after the invention of blast furnace, the smelting of iron became easy. Now the iron which was produced by this was of good quality, because they were using the blast furnace used the coal, and that generated high temperature which was required to produce good quality of coal. So iron. Now second Derby. Now you can see three Derbys are here. First Derby, he invented blast furnace. Then second Derby developed the wrought iron from the pig iron. This was required because different shapes are required in the factories. Rods are required, pipes are required. So this was done because of the invention of second Derby. Then the next name is Henry Cort. Henry Cort also developed purling furnace and rolling mills. Then John Wilkinson made the first iron chair. After the invention of iron chair, it was easy for the workers. They were able to take some support or rest for some time. Then the vats were also built. Vats means they were keeping the liquid in this container. This was a sort of tank or container, you can say. So pipes were built, iron chairs were built, vats were built. These inventions brought a lot of change in industries. Now third Derby. First Derby, blast furnace, the second Derby, then now this is the third Derby. They all, this Derby family was a master, iron master. Third Derby, this is important also, he built the first iron bridge in the world. First iron bridge in the world, you can see this is the iron bridge, or this is over the Severn River. This is it, over the Severn River in Coalbrookdale. And still this is bridge is there. Many more bridges were built after that, but this is the first bridge made of iron. Now next we come to cotton spinning and weaving. Cotton spinning and weaving, when we say cotton spinning and weaving, first of all, you know, in Britain they were using flax and wool for weaving the clothes. Flax and wool was used. Now they started using cotton also. In the beginning, they were taking bale of cotton from India, from their colonies of Britain. Now some changes took place, some inventions were there, some machines were built. Now they were not taking only cotton bales, now they were taking cotton cloth, now they were taking cotton, the raw material cotton they were taking from India, and with the help of machines they were manufacturing it, and they were sending the manufactured goods in the market of India. So in this way they were earning a lot of money. So Till the 18th century, spinning was very slow. But when new technology came, many machines were invented, it became easy for them to manufacture cloth in factories. Cotton textile manufacturing areas, you can see, same areas are there. That is why when we say development or industrial revolution, it was not equal. The effect was not equal in all the areas. In, you can see particularly in this area or in London. This is the main area where industrial revolution took place. It was not same in all the areas. So you can see the main areas of cotton textile and manufacturing industries. Now some inventions were done. These are very important inventions and this is important for you for one mark question also. They can ask the name of the machine and you are supposed to write the inventor, or they can ask the inventor, they can give the name of machine. First of all, John Kay, he invented flying shuttle. John Kay invented flying shuttle. Then James Hargreaves, he invented spinning jenny. The spinning jenny was invented by James Hargreaves. Then Richard Arkwright, he invented water frame. Samuel Crompton, he invented mule. And Edmund Cartwright, he invented power loom. After the invention of these machines, the work became easier and faster. The quality also improved. Now it was easy for them to produce more and more goods in less time. Second thing, then it also reduced the labor charges, because machines were taking place of labor. 100 laborers were employed for the same thing. Now only one machine was doing the work of 100 people. And they were also producing good quality of cloth. Now steam power was also invented, and that was the main, you can say, reason of the development of railways and to run the machines. And this was the easiest, or you can say the cheapest mean of energy, because water is abundantly available and this was the cheapest mean of energy. And when the people realized that they could generate steam, they could generate power with the help of a steam, then it brought a drastic change in the field of industrial revolution. Then some steam engines were built by different inventors, like you can say Thomas Savery was there, then Newcomen was also there, but all these steam engines were having some defects. Final and the best one we can say was invented by James Watt. Here you can see also some inventions were there, some steam locomotives, railways, these all were running with the help of a steam engine or steam power. Then this is the engine that was built by James Watt, and this was that and the best one, and it was used for a long time. Later on some changes were made, but the basic concept of steam engine was given by James Watt, which were in use, and that was used in many factories, especially in coal mines it was used. Okay, then now canals and railways, why they were built? They were built for the transportation, of course. Canals were used for the transportation. And you will be surprised to know that the canals were in the beginning built for that purpose only. For what purpose? For the transporting of coal. As you know, coal is a heavy, bulky item. Coal is a bulky, is heavy in weight. So just to transport coal, this canal was built by Worsley. This name of the canal was Worsley Canal. It was built by James Brindley just to transport the coal. And after the construction of the canal, the price of the coal reduced to 50%. Why? Because transportation charges are also added in the final charges. When transportation became cheaper, then what happened? Then the price is reduced to 50%. Now they were, maybe those who were the landlords, the big owners, those who were the rich, they were taking interest in this. The canals were usually built by big landowners to increase the value of the mines, quarries or forest on their land. Because after the construction of the canals, the value of these areas were becoming more. Then this canals paved the way for the emergence of new markets also. And the phase 1788 to 1796, this phase was known as Canal Mania, because this phase, during this period, a lot of canals were constructed. In the same way, you will see there was रेलवे मीनिया, बिग रेलवे एंड स्मॉल रेलवे मीनिया. फर्स्ट स्टीम लोकोमोटिव वॉज इन्वेंटेड बाय स्टीफेंसन, स्टीफेंसन रॉकेट, नेम वॉज स्टीफेंसन रॉकेट एंड इट वॉज इन्वेंटेड बाय स्टीफेंसन. ओके, देन द आयरन ट्रैक. इन द बिगनिंग यू टूडे यू हैव सीन द ट्रैक्स आर मेड ऑफ आयरन, बट एट दैट टाइम इट वॉज मेड ऑफ वुड. You will be surprised to know, some of you may not be knowing this thing. So the tracks were made of wood. Now the wooden tracks were replaced by the iron tracks. After 1760s, they were replaced by iron tracks. Richard Trevithick, he devised an engine that was known as puffing devil, because the sound it was producing, puff puff, that is why it was known as puffing devil. Then the George Stephenson, he also constructed the steam power, that was the Blücher. Then the first railway line, this is again one, this is all for one marker also in this chapter. One marker questions are, so many questions are there. So first railway line, please keep it in your mind. First railway line was constructed between cities of Stockton and Darlington. Stockton and Darlington, between Darlington and Stockton. As you know, in India, it was from Mumbai to Thane in 1853. But here, it was Stockton to Darlington, first railway line. And second was Liverpool to Manchester. Second railway line was from Liverpool to Manchester. There was big railway mania and small railway mania. When there was small railway mania, that time 1400 miles long railway lines, railway tracks were constructed. And during the period of big railway mania, 9500 miles tracks were constructed. That is why the period was known as big railway mania and small railway mania. This you can see, wooden tracks, the train is running on wooden tracks. Today we are having iron tracks, but at that time it was wooden tracks. Right. So this is all about the first part. Now in next part we will be discussing how the workers were working in the factory. What was the condition of the worker and what was the condition of women? What steps were taken by the government to improve their condition? Okay, thank you. Keep watching.